Anyway, I'm from Croatia, Zagreb, and here I will represent my maker Space Radiona and company Intergalactic. First, I just want to thank organizers for accepting my talk and allowing me longer presentation. I will also want to thank open source community for supporting us from the start. In this presentation, I will talk about open source hardware, especially about the FPGA boards, ULX3S and ULX4M. So let's get started. Just a little bit about me. I spent most of my working time, around 15 years, on repairs, starting from IT equipment and ending on banking equipment repair. So I was quite familiar how devices look like from inside and how components are interconnected. That experience took me to the next level of designing and programming industrial IoT devices, mostly different types of smart meters. After that, me, Deborah and Damek from Radiona opened a company called Intergalactic that is focused on open source solutions. I'm a member of Radiona for around 10 years. It is really great place for expanding creativity, to meet people that think on a different way, to hang out and do collaboration projects with others. In Radiona, there is a lot of members from different fields and different skills, like electronics, arts, design. Combining those skills and collaborating, we are creating really interesting future. As this presentation will be both talk about FPGAs, let me try to oversimplify about FPGAs. So if I have one sentence to describe what FPGAs, I will say something like this. If you can imagine really big number of programmable switches placed inside the devices. By programming those switches to be on or off, you can get any digital logic. And after some time you will spend in writing AGDL, AGDL is hardware description language, you will notice that it is really similar to putting chips on the breadboard and connecting them with wires. So with AGDL, you are not programming like on MCU, you are describing how hardware will look like. And now just a bit of history about ULX3S. ULX3S was developed in 2016 as a need of improvement of ULX2X that was used in the Faculty of Electronic Engineering in Zagreb. Davor and Marko agreed on the features every student would need for learning digital logic, and Davor started hardware development. At that time, I was just helping them with some ideas. ULX2S is designed by Marko X, is looking like this. Design was not available at all, and a production company that did production for a university lost design files at some point. So Marko and Dava agreed that the only solution for a new board is to be open from start, with design files available for everyone. On the ULX3S, they decided to go with Lattice ACP5 FPGA chip. Dava put a lot of effort to make board compatible with different ECP5 sizes. On ULX3S, we can use 12F, 45F, 85F, and with small correction on one power supply, we can also use UM and UM5G devices. We have discovered that 12F is enough for most of the project, but most sellable device is still 85F. Second part of ULX3S is SDRAM memory. Maximum memory on ULX3S can have 64 megabytes, but we have only one batch with 64 megabytes. All other batches are 34 megabytes, as that is mostly enough. Idea behind SDRAM over DDR memory was some already done projects like Minimic Oberon Next1X6 and similar retro projects. At that time, free FPGA board also had SDRAM, so we wanted to be more compatible. As for the programming, ULX3S can be programmed over US1 USB connector that is connected directly to FPGA chip. For programming, we are mostly using WIPROC, that is fork of Marko Z's WIPROC, but there are also other tools like OpenFPGA Loader. Beside US1 connector, we also have US2 connector that is directly connected to FPGA pins. We can use that connector for USB bootloader, or we can use it as USB host, and has some external devices like keyboard, mouse, or joystick connected. just in case something goes wrong, word is also programmable over JTAG connector. Along with the JTAG connector, on top of it, there is also OLED connector placeholder. For bigger data, we have SD card. We can use it in SDI mode or 4-bit mode. SD card has shared connections between FPGA and ESP32, so devices can talk with the card, of course, not on the same time. On the board, there are also 8 LEDs. 8 was a great number, as repeat, we can represent full byte. On FPGA designs, LEDs are easy way of debugging some internal signals, so you will always need more LEDs. There is no fancy step-by-step debugging in FPGA, but you can always assign some signals to LED and check what is happening. As for the outputs, we also have GPDI, General Purpose Differential Interface, that we are mostly using for outputting DVI video signals. HDMI monitors are mostly compatible with DVI signaling, so you can get picture on most monitors or televisions. Next connector can be used for audio or video output. For audio, we are using simple 4-bit resistor divider. On the board, we have 7 buttons that are organized like a joystick, so we can play retro game directly on those buttons. Only one button, button 0, has inverted logic, and we are mostly using that button for reset. That button can also be used for powering board on and off, and if one dial is added to the board, we can use that button as a multi-boot jump, so we can jump to our next bitstream in flash. As an input, we also have 4 DIP switches, as switches are really always useful. Last thing on the top side is a small ADC. It is 12-bit ADC that can have 8 single-ended inputs or 4 differential inputs. Idea behind adding ADC was from Arduino, as users always want to add some external analog devices, or just have your potentiometer. On the bottom side, we have 3 power supplies. We are using Texas Instrument chip that can provide up to 2 amps of current. If we are placed UM or UM4G chip, we just need to change one resistor to get 1.2 volts instead of standard 1.2. It can also be used for overclocking. This is just a FPGA chip that is used for FPGA programming, but also as a USB to serial interface to FPGA logic. In new version, we have switched to QFN version of the same chip. As FPGA starts, it always starts empty, and depending on settings, checks for the bitstream. In our case, bitstream can be placed in flash. In flash, we have 64 megabytes of flash, so sometimes we are also using it for other purposes like holding ROM games. One of the special features of the ULX3S is RTC chip that has small memory that can hold a lot. So we can use this setup to have RTC in, for example, Linux, but the design is also made in a way that RTC can provide wake alarm for the board. Board can be powered down, and on alarm it can wake up. While in power down mode, it only consumes 10 microamps. Battery is only to keep RTC time. So you will still need to provide 5 volts for the board. Last thing on the back of the board is ESP32. And as designs of ESP32 changes, we have a footprint design that in that way, so it can hold rover or ROM modules of versions of ESP32. ESP32 arises with preloaded MicroPython, and combining external MCU and FPGAs gives endless possibilities. One of the cool usage of ESP32 is having OSD overlay on the top of the FPGA picture. So in retro games, you can browse SD card and load game ROM on the fly. ESP32 also gives this board wireless and Bluetooth, so we can connect to external network, or we can use Bluetooth for different things. Once I was using USB32 to connect to external Bluetooth speaker, so I had FPGA sound core playing sound on external Bluetooth speaker. And here's how current version of the board looks like. A few more things I didn't mention. Oscillator on the board is 25 MHz. Why? This value is not so important, and you can use internal PLL to get almost any clock value. We have three more LEDs that are used for serial connection and ESP32 identification. On each side we have 40 pins that are arranged in a way to be PMOD compatible. Out of 56 pins on header, 28 are differential pairs. Small FEM connector is here so we can call ESP32 in reset, just in case it takes over the SD card. And G5 can be used to switch left bank's voltage to 2.5 volts, or we can provide other smaller external voltages like 1.8 volt if needed. On the top right side of the header, there is also 5 volt input output, so you can provide 5 volt over that connector or use USB and have 5 volt out for external peripheral devices. Just a quick overview of the front side of the board and the back side of the board. Campaign on the ULX board was quite successful, and until now we have sold and delivered around 2,000 boards. Those are really high numbers for a small startup like this. There is so many other things I did not mention about this board, so I will show you a campaign video that is showing a lot of interesting projects that are running on this board. Enjoy 2 minute video while I am having a sip of water. In the video that we are mostly using open source toolchain. ULX3S would never be so popular if offered open tools are not available, so our big thanks goes to Yozo's HQ team. that is making enormous effort in providing open and available toolchain. Thank you, USHQ. So after campaign, we could not sell that amount of work over our makerspace. So we have decided to open a company that will handle everything around ULX3S and be focused on new open source hardware software solutions. We named the company Intergalactic. Once work was produced, we needed to have some mesh testing. We already had internal tests that was good for checking if work is okay. But when you have thousands of words at once, you need some scripting. Dobrica Pavlovicic helped us on this first batch and made our awesome batch script testing. Batch script was great when I was doing it, but once I switched testing to a production company, they were quite lost with those scripts. So I had asked Nbox if they can help us. A month later, I got this fancy GUI tester that any production company can understand. There is a bunch of ULX3S examples out there. So we have created, let's call it startup page, that we are refreshing from time to time to include every project we found. And my GitHub is also full of ULX3S goodies. So make sure you check missed examples that are covering all work peripherals. We have also designed a lot of open extensions for the ULX3S, and we are currently selling three of them. First is the USB extension that gives you two additional USB host ports, as for some projects you will need mouse and keyboard, or even joystick. GPDI can be used for additional GPDI output. It can also be used as DVI input. We have samples of getting 640 by 480 input, but it may need a bit more work as timings is not automated, so you need to finally adjust timings with the buttons to get stable picture. Bit high resolutions also work, but it is harder to get timings right, and high resolutions can have more noise. The last extension we are selling is for OV camera. You can use up to two extensions of one ULX3S port. Check other extensions on my GitHub account. As for our availability of ULX3S and extension ports, you can check CrowdSupply, Mouser, or NXR. Or you can contact me directly. I have already mentioned NX. They have great open source projects. So at some point, we decided to collaborate and combine BV3 measuring equipment with ULX3S. We did manage to do it, but it was painful to combine EEZ MCU board and ULX3S, as any NX boards was done in Eagle, and ULX3S designs are in TCAD. After adding FPGA to NX projects, others started to ask the same. So I was thinking, why not make ULX3S modular, so everyone can easily put a connector and have FPGA in the system. ULX3S has too many components for that, and it was big too big for integration. So I have asked MLNet Foundation, will they help me making modular version of the board, and they accepted my offer. So they are financing development of two modular boards. As making connector fit is not easy, we are also decided to have 3D models first, and MLNet also agreed on financing 3D modeling and experimenting with Blender. All 3D work is done by Paolo Lucha, also a developer. And here are some pictures from the Blender. Paolo also need to use FreeCAD at some point, as there is not easy way of importing geometry into Blender. You can read more about Blender progress at intergalactic.eu under news, as we are trying to record our progress in the blog. We have tested different connectors, but at the end we got to a conclusion that connector that is used on Raspberry CM4 module is good enough for everything our board will offer. It is also available and cheap.
And once we have selected that connector, we got to a conclusion that we can also be pin compatible with CM4 IO. As with compatibility, we will get a bigger range already existing CMIO based ports. So our first board was SD-RAM, and on V002 we managed to squeeze 2 buttons and 4 LEDs. Additional to ULX3S, ULX4M will all offer usage of service pin and maybe CSI and VSI. On DDR3 prototype, we managed to add one more button and added 4 more LEDs, as they are so important in debugging. Also, this version adds 2 DIP switches, and most important, we have added USB connectors, so we can use this board even without baseboard. For that purpose, we will just need to use the USB bootloader, as USB pins are connected directly to the FPGA. DDR3 board also had place for the 1 gigabit Ethernet chip. Everything is connected, but we are currently unable to find that chip, so we will need to redesign or wait a bit longer until the chip becomes available. In the next revision, SD-RAM version of the board will also have everything that DDR3 board now has. ULX4M is now 6-layer board. There are 3 signal legs, 2 ground planes, and 1 power plane leg. As I already mentioned, boards are fully open, and you can check design at the intergalactic GitHub. As for compatibility, for the moment we have released first version of the board. We are getting and buying lots of already designed IO boards and fixing compatibility issues if they arise. Latest we have received is this awesome open hardware tablet that usually holds Raspberry CM4 module, but it can also fit ULX4M. Currently, we still do not have any sample of driving MIDI screen, but hopefully at some point we will manage to get something on the screen.
这边要给一个 shout out。 这一台是 Qt 牌，是来自于台湾原本有一位在 Canonical 服务的员工叫 Pank， 然后后来现在人在那个 Qt， 就是做 GUI 的那个 Qt 的 Qt， 他自己本身很喜欢业余时间喜欢打造这一些 Open Source 的东西，包含他自己很喜欢做，他之前还有去接过那个电影道具的制作，有点像那个我不知道各位有没有看那个《流言终结者》，有一个那个最近过世的那位那个。 就很像那种感觉。那其中这台Qt牌是他打造，然后我当个中间桥梁，把这一台寄给这个在克罗埃西亚的，就是讲者。然后克罗埃西亚讲者地址超短的，我跟 Pank 两个看一下，觉得这会不会他给错？然后克罗埃西亚，然后那位讲者就是这位 Goran，
The goal of having completely down to last transistor open Linux with frame buffer is now achieved. Check out how DDR3 is put in Linux on Linux.
He said that it's FPGA版，所以他把它接到他那台，就我们那台上面，然后 HDMI 打出来。他说因为那个 screen 是走那个 DSI， 那 DSI 没有 open source 的那个就是 display 的 IP， 所以他就先打 HDMI 出来到外面这样，这是他这一部分的 design。
So I'm just mounting the SD card，and I am okay just copying picture to memory, and I'm sending this picture to frame buffer.
He GDI
DDR3 version also has enough memory to run simple X system. And for the end, yes, it can also run.
Thank you. So if you need something, you can contact me on the Jitter or Discord. You can follow up Radiona or Intergalactic EU on the Twitter. And yes, you can send an email on warp@intergalactic.eu. And thank you.
好，基本上就是这位讲者是一个很有，我发现因为就最后一场，让我稍微拉塞一下。这位是我，其实我还在念大学吧，大四那年的时候，他们做，他有跟他讲，他是克罗埃西亚的首府的那个叫萨格列布大学。那他们其实是一个有点类似像算社团这一类的感觉，就是一群其实。因为其实不像台湾人，其实这种就是很多你18岁上个大学这件事情其实很稀松平常。可是在其实很多国家，其实他们上大学这件事情其实是非常非常耗费所费不赀的。他可能要去国外工作几年或者念书，对，所以他们其实这些虽然讲说是学生社团，可是其实年纪都不见得比我们就是18岁，然后有些可能30几岁我去念大学这样。对，那他们在念大学的时候就觉得，因为像台湾这种你可以很轻易的说上网，然后什么 eBay， 然后 APJ 就买过来，这其实是很。在国外，尤其是东欧国家，看起来就觉得很莫名其妙的是，在东欧国家，他们那个其实你就像最近就在打仗嘛，就是那个其实是一个，就是其实资源不丰，他们就会想说，那我要自己能不能自己做个 APJ 开发板，然后而且他们也不见得有经费可以去买 Cylinks 的，那个时候那个年代 Cylinks 还没有 Webpack， 那个年代 Cylinks 啊，然后 Terra 这种都是要。配的那个 EDA 拖圈，所以他们找了一些 open source EDA 拖圈，然后自己去类 PCB 板，然后最后做了一张 APJ 开发板出来。然后那时候我还在念大学，我就写信跟他讲说，我觉得好有趣，我想要玩一张。然后那时候还没有，那时候 PayPal 好像很他的国家很麻烦。然后最后我还是去银行去办那个 wire transfer， 去把钱给他，就连 PayPal 他都不见得能够收。那我们就千几百块把那张板子搞过来之后，然后就开始就也是学，就是因为那时候其实在念大学念书的电路，然后就开始在玩一些那种，那个时候还没有 RISC-V， 那时候叫 Open RISC， 就是另外一种 architecture， 一个很小的 RISC-V， 那其实白算盘有个 DEX 的架构，然后拿去改的叫 Open RISC 这样，然后那时候就开始玩说啊 Linux 可以布起来，然后可以 porting 这样棒棒这样 anyway， 然后后来就他到现在是出到第四代，他刚刚有讲他从 ULX2S 然后 3S 然后现在 4M。就他其实做到第四代的 APJ 版，然后也是认识很久的老朋友，所以我刚刚讲说，他后来他刚刚就讲说，我觉得你要挪我时间可以啦，可是我实在后面有事情了，不然我送个音，我就 video 丢给你，你自己播这样，所以就变成这样了。就是最后，因为刚刚那位你也刚各位在座都知道，那个日本讲者那一段那个实在变动太大，就超出了那个常态的 range， 就变成这样了，对，所以。蛮有趣的，我就觉得，我最后就做个就这个 track 最后的总结，就是我们虽然说我自己本身也是一间 CPUIP 公司，但其实在业余时间还有就业时间，然后其实都有很多这种 open hardware 的 track 跟 community， 在台湾可能没有那么红，那就是在国外其实蛮多的。那也就是如果你想玩 open source 的，不管 EDA 是给 APJ 还是给 ASIC， 今天都听到了。那甚至连 PCB 板，它用 KiCad 的，它是在一个就是随时旁边可能都会爆发战争的国家，他去弄那个 PCB 板出来，为了他们自己的就是学习跟就是玩，也讲玩乐也是一部分，然后做这样的东西。其实我觉得台湾人要玩这个也很简，也不难。对，那很感谢各位今天陪伴我们这个学到最后，小弟再次一鞠躬，谢谢谢谢。哦，感谢感谢，那我就把直播给切了。
300的Open Source的，我知道有1310，还有其他的。
31跟那个U500，我们有两颗，真的不好意思，大哥，那个
真
的
麻烦
了，
我
真
的。
哦，是，
不要，对，我最近的确也有考虑要那个下潜啊，还是这方面的东西。对，
谢谢，
谢谢。
不，您说其实，好吧，就是现在都已经直播切掉了，就其实公司已经做，已经离开做梦的时间有点远了，所以说我们都等后台湾录音。
越对，
越少。
对，没错，对，我也这样觉得。
对，其实我反正今天大家都是好玩的，就是 Rivers 那边应该会有，
因为
RIVOS 就是其实我们自己在外面都有个开玩笑讲到说 all the cool kids， all the cool kids are at sci-fi at Rivers now。就是其实我们那边其实在这一两年有一些当年草创，就是那种很一
人、第十人，就是从
是
牺牲收费到他 T O 全部
全部都全部都一个一手包，
一手包那种大神，现在都在 Reforms。
OK，
对对对，就是因为就这边其实就是开始要就不动负责，原本原调以后是没有打那场战争，其实搞不好年底又要来 T O 了。
是是。
然后现在打完，现在自从他叫 P O 个 P，
对
啊對，对，所以就其实他们为了要开始冲一些 revenue， 其实就很多那种比较排名的人就开始渐渐变少。
是，
对，那可是就我觉得看人的选择啊，我个人是觉得就是我今年也30几了，我想要好好过生活，没有想要再去 Reverse 再闯荡一次。对，尤其是有一些那种比较年轻的，我心里没有很大，就是跟那种20几岁的人就觉得啊，因为感觉就 Reverse 玩一玩好了。
是，
然后我们这种就会觉得好累。对对对，就是。
所以 Reverse 的话是怎么拼啊？
RIVOS。他们在台湾其实有招人，然后 power software 都有了，只是他们现在这种就是很 stealth mode 的那种情况，其实都是不见得会真的有 open position 给你看，就是说你就写信过去跟他讲说，我很想要加入你们公司，他们就会回一封信说，那我们来台湾不管哪个咖啡厅喝个咖啡，
对对对，大家聊一下，
对对对对对对，像 Sapphire 这种已经是有点比较就是正规化，就是 HR 啦，然后会计啊什么，就用我们。反正就现在这种，
你们成长的好快啊！对，
对，真的成长很快。可是他现在已经变得很官僚，就是我们九月要去外面讲，就是我九月其实要去读柏林讲那个我们公司的一些算就是 contribution 啦。因为我们虽然讲说是开始做工，可是还是会有些东西是想要去 steer 这种 open， 因为有些东西你是架构性的，你今天 open source 的那些 framework 可以当定性而已，后面要动它很难动，
是是。
所以我们会尽量去想哦，但我们也不是恶意，可是就是有些东西 design 上它有 choice， 那我们会想要去 sway 这种，比如说像我是在做克隆这一段，就克隆某些 mechanism， 我们希望这样做，要去 promote 我们的做法。
是是，
对。那机票钱，然后老外就说，你这个不能 virtual 参加就好吗？你一定要 in flight 吗？我就想说，你们 COVID 都结束了，我不能，对啊，为什么不能坐飞机？然后他就想说，好了，我们再帮你争取一下。我心里想。我靠！人家也是要 IPO 了，然后就开始在确认这些东西东看西看嘞，妈的！不过我是觉得，其实因为好了，我觉得老实说，我其实学历不好，我是教大家念到一半，硕班就退学的那种。因为我玩这种东西玩太凶了，就是玩到老板就觉得你真的有要念硕班吗？你这个还是去外面闯荡好了。然后就对我后来就自主退学了。然后其实后来也是闯荡很久啊，就是我看一下我可以去有一些那种其实像四大 IT 公司就不用讲，第一步去就是我们是要去缅甸巴克，巴克就说这个可能16哦，这个助攻而且要签到，
算了，
对，然后想说算了，后来就在小公司打转，比如像金星也是一间很照顾我的公司，
是，
对，就后来就反正人总是有很多换来换去的地方，对，你们是学生吗？还是是
哦，
最后人是哦，
谢谢。
对，写分位的 ，OK 的，哎、欸，我们还是
我是做 ED 的，
你做 ED， 该不会是就三玉三家的？
没有，是新创的。
哦，新创，新创做 ED，Mac
ED，
哦，这么新。
然后我开始是在入资啊，我在新华章，然后后来我到台湾。
哦，新华章我知道那个，了解了解。
哦，我好奇，我很想问一下，就是看到是你们。FPGA 版都是自己做的，那个 PC 版的话，你们是有软体可以自己画这样画自己的
要、欸。你是说 PC 版要怎么画吗？
对 ，PC 版是有软体。
有 KICAD。对，
就那个也算 EDA 还是？
它是一种就 PCB 的 EDA 吧，那个跟就是我现在的 FPGA EDA 跟 AC EDA 就是不太一样，差蛮远的，对不对？哎、欸，所以说教授您也是做这种？
我就有玩玩啦、啊，最近有想要碰一下这方面的东西。
了解了解，對對
對，我只是兼任而已的，我自己本身还在做音乐。
哦，
对对
对，了解了解。那也是老，那我们原本 coscard 其实跟中学是、
对啊，没错，对 对，我在 coscard 的还蛮多人的，对，像之前总知道小 B 跟我还算熟，然
后老朋友了，老朋友了，对对 对。好，我可能还要再收一下，那就不打扰了，
没问题，没问题，
谢谢
。我可以跟你交换。
哦，好，没问题，好的，没问题。LinkedIn 的部分，我应该要怎么跟你交换会比较好？我跟你说。 我直接开 LinkedIn 好了，然后打您的 ID 这样。不过我 LinkedIn 上的资讯有一点久没有更新了，我最近因为这几个月其实真的太忙，考试微轻度，这位吗？
对对对。
Okay. 好，没问题，没问题。
好，谢谢。
这个样子。
考试是做什么？发掘。
跟一些
那就发了我嘛，就是
我出一起把它兜起来。
OK，
谢谢。
好，我就是 OK， 好 ，OK， 好。你的我和那个你的，
有
我没问题，我查一下。
你找我应该会比较快，因为我叫 Peter。
哦，好，黄耀先生，您好，您好。
有
这个吗 ？OK， 好，了解了解。好的，没问题，那就不多打扰，不多打扰。
谢谢。
以后那个我们班有 email 就多联络，多联络。
好，没问题，谢。有一些问题到时候再请教。
其实，我抱歉，可能就当我多嘴问一下好了。我蛮好奇说，就是您会想要承接这样的一个 track 吗？
不会。
我了解了，我了解，您就我这样听得懂了，对不对？对啊，也是因为其实真的是做起来有点。你现在弄到第二届，我是觉得有点累，因为我在想说台湾不知道有没有人比较有兴趣。
你说整个这样子的，
对吧、啊？要去筹办这样的一个活动，就是应该说这个轨道啦，就是大活动一定是附在那个，就是他们 Costco 底下。
对。
如果 Costco 大家比较会参与的主题是。
比较 spin software， 我们这种都是异类，对，你就光看今天的人数就知道了。
我其实蛮讶异的，所以说今年怎么会那么多？从
台湾硬体王国怎么？
对，
垃圾收回。
其实这部分我当然教授那边可能有更好的 comment， 不过我听到的版本是说，像 EDA 这种，其实他们因为很多产学合作，就是 NDA 签的非常的严格，但是严格到说会是，
了解，
就是可能。就是比如说，你甚至不能出来讲说你遇到什么问题。就是他们的，我听到的讲法是，就是他们跟我讲说，就是有些EDA公司会觉得说，这你知道这问题的点在哪里，就其实后面就大家知道是你在大概遇到什么问题了。
对，
知道
吗？就是那种反而不会那么 open 的让，希望让大家分享说我做了些什么事。
对对对，就是那个敏感度很高，
太高了，太高了。
对。所以其实我觉得可能，其实好奇就是老师您主要做的领域是，
我这样做的东西跟演算法比较关，
演算法吗？哦，是该不是毕业演算法那边的？
没有
，GoPro 之类的，
没有
，GoPro 老铁，
做布局电路的，
所以是实际上想要兜一下这个 RISC-V 的处理器，那甚至于把一些不要说的东西加上去，
了解。
就是搭个小系统，那我实际上有稍微看过一些，所以才会说我知道 free license 有E310 FE310 然后对，大概是
如果您
但是那个已经，我觉得那个我记得你们应该是124系列是跟 Cortex M4 比较接近，
对，
310已经比124还要再大嘛，对。
如果您是要真的很小code的，其实钱东家那边有。就是 NDIS
有 N2 跟
N25 25可能25其实已经是那种 MPU 等级了，
是
对，那22应该是您要的 class， 然后如果您要买 RISC-V 的 core 的话，中国那边如果不排斥，那有一间叫那个新来 Nuclei 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 新来科技，然后当然您说平头哥那是一定啊，平头哥也是有做这种Embedded Code 的，可是如果是 Open Source 的话，
我可能先用 Open Source。
Open Source 的话，我个人很推一颗，我不知道您有没有兴趣，叫您去查，就这个数字有点长，您可能真的需要用机器啦，就 CV32140P， ABCD 的
140P。
那您知道这一颗？
我知道这一颗。对，这一颗
是真的有拿去。Tape out， 然后有 production 的，它有一间，我记得是法国公司叫 Green Waves， 然后它有拿去做 Tape out， 而且它有它自己特殊的 DSP 的 extension，
是，
然后其实他们主打是低功耗的，就是如果您是有这种就是需求，我觉得应该是非常非常适合。
有，我听过这个， 对，所以你也推这一颗、啊？
我非常推那一颗。如果您是学术要用，然后而且甚至未来可能要商转的话，我觉得这颗应该是蛮适合的。
好，好好。
因为他们CP 三个是一个 family， 就是他们还有 CP 三 140S 吧，要做那个 security extension 的，然后跟 CP 三 140X， 他们预计要拿去做就是 coprocessor 的 interface 来去接其他的 module。对，我觉得其实 CP 三个整个系列是一个还蛮，虽然我自己本身是做 CPU provider， 可是我觉得蛮佩服他们。
是，
对，
就是CP 三个这一系列。
这一系列，对。
好的，
所以您有在跑欧陆的研讨会吗？因为其实他们就是这一挂人在 Foston， 其实
我八月十号出国，九月到欧洲。
哦，
所以我九月的会议跟这些比较没关系，
其实他们几个就是那个 ETH 的处那个叫 Luca Benini 嘛，我有点忘记，反正就是他们那几位。就是当初 CP3140P 的前身叫 Risky RIS， 对，他们几位都非常非常健谈。然后其实我之前还在前公司的时候，那时候因为玩 Back， 然后玩一玩，就觉得说想要看看 Open Source Core 的效能。然后那时候他们讲说他们的 Vector Extension Core 要 Open Source， 可是玩了大概半年一年还没有给 Core，
是。
然后我就写说啊，我很有兴趣想要做一下 Benchmarking， 不知道你们 Core 先给我，
是是是，
然后就把 Core 寄过来，然后还说就是哦，我们很好奇说就是 commercial 的 vector core provider 怎么看这件事，然后后来就跟他聊一下，其实因为我觉得其实他们这些欧陆人对这种事情其实还蛮 open 的，不像台湾，其实你很多人会我不是、那個、
对台湾的确是会东长一点西长一点，或者这个不能讲那个不能讲，
他会讲说哦，我这个可能有跟哪个东西有合作，對對對對對，
其实这个样子，对对对
对。
好，
没问题，
谢谢。然后他后来告诉我说，他们现在没有
电池了，
因为那个时候是
目前做的是
电池，然后就没有传这样。后来就告诉我说，如果有机会再联络一下。然后反正我后来后来是接触的是三菱。那个我是想问说，就是说三菱他的那些产品，他那些晶片就是有一个 slice 的那个产品，就是说都是 slice， 就是让我比较知道说这个，因为它里面的晶体。然后那个配合几个 get 出来的位置嘛，那可是他那张1515，然后他们我不知道那个，
不知道怎么看嘛，
但是我不知道他们的怎么
接到
那个，他那个，
我懂，我怎么评估我的那个，就是我东西到底合不合得上去的一些，
就是他有没有这种产品？
其实不太多，可以
问一下那个 slide 的话，
会再给你。对，反正有零件。
好，对，我再
就应该说，我们应该会在会后大概可能。就最晚一个月了，我们尽量把 slide 都放到那个 Postcard 的官网。你等得到那时候吗？
可以。
好，可能那就大概一个月后在 Postcard 官网就发得到。
哦，在
官网
上面，不是在 HKMD 不是？
他什么？
不是在 HKMD 里面，不是。
HK 也可以，我们应该说我们这边就会反正统一把它就是最后全部都丢给就是大会啊，大会要放在哪里，就是、我是不是很确定。
哦、
HKMD 有可能，就我已经有点久没有。handle 那一段，对，我应该会就反而会到时候会，要么是在别人地方，就是那个他第二个地方，对，我是那个，对，我正结束了，对不对？
好，谢谢哦。
不然你们应该就哦，好，没事，好，OK， 拜拜。